Well, 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 look who decided to show their face here again, and I appreciate that you did. Today we're going to be working on some new projects over in Saltwater, but first we're going to wander around aimlessly in the basement, because of course I've added some more stuff down here. It's a mess. It's spaghetti pipes all over the place. So as you can see, we've got some new crops coming in. These are from our brand new farms that we have in the wall over here, color-coded as usual. So last episode, when I was building the music shop, I noticed I didn't have any melons on hand, or pumpkins for that matter. So we have a melon and pumpkin farm right here, a little bit of a small one, but it is, you know, feeding us with more melons and pumpkins that we're probably ever going to need, as well as a cactus farm for that green dye. And then, of course, in case I end up ever using, you know, packed mud, we need some wheat. So we've got a 3-layer villager wheat farm here as well. And that is all filtering down into our storage system right here. So we have everything separated out. And then, of course, composting any excess and seeds as well along the way. Also over here, as part of one of the things that we're going to be building today, we have a very small kelp farm that's in here. So that's also more kelp than I'm ever going to need. So anyways, let's head on back up and talk a little bit more about what we're going to be doing today. All right, this is it. Prime real estate down here in the sewer. We're going to be building an arcade along this wall here. It's actually going to be going into the wall a bit. And inside, we're going to have, well, not really arcade games. No, it's a little bit of gambling, maybe. Going to be doing a couple slot machines. And I'm bringing back something from my very first SMP from TH Klassen. It is Roll'em Shulkers, and I will explain what that is very soon, but it's something I've been wanting to build ever since I saw him build that on the first SMP I was on, which was Collusion MC, and it's very awesome. Are you trying to escape? I saw you up there. You're not. It's not going to happen. I've blocked this all off there. Yeah, go on your way, Michelangelo. Anyways, so yeah, we're going to be building up an arcade and playing with more of that colored lighting again, because I've really enjoyed the way that looks just with the different builds and everything and the colored lights. I think you're gonna really like this, so I'm gonna get that built and let's take a look at that final product. All right guys, it's done, the Galaxy Arcade. Let's take a look. This is the brand new sewer arcade that I built down here. It's kind of half arcade. Okay, mostly gambling hall. You can't really make arcade games in Minecraft, but you can make a pretty immersive environment using lots of custom music discs. So we have the different arcade games playing their little sound effects, including my mock-up DDR machine. I've got a couple stand-up arcade games. And yeah, I've got a claw machine as well, and then some just general casino arcade ambiance. This has kind of a space theme to it. So of course we have Space Porp up in the air with his wonderful rocket ship from last season. And then over here in Roll'em Shulkers, we have Arrington and Beta standees, which are pretty awesome. Also threw up some pixel art graffiti on the wall of some of the robot masters. And yeah, we've got a few games that you can actually play inside of this arcade. So starting off with Roll'em Shulkers. Roll'em Shulkers is a game that comes from my early SMP days. Back when TH Klassen built this on Collusion MC Season 1. This is actually his game design in his shop that he had in the shopping district. Way this works is it's kind of a game of luck, in the sense that you don't know what's inside of these shulker boxes, and they're not exactly cheap. It costs 2 diamond blocks, but I guarantee that at least some of these are gonna have a lot more than 2 diamond blocks worth of goodies inside. So let's take a look here. We're gonna go ahead and cycle through some of these until we find a color that, you know, speaks to us. How about gray? Let's do gray, shall we? All right, so I'm going to throw a couple diamond blocks into the barrel here, or dropper. We're going to hit the button twice. Once. Twice. And... and our prize! And our celebratory rockets! This is a whoosh box, so you get a bunch of rockets. So not necessarily worth two diamonds, but still pretty good. Let's try our luck again. Let's see what else we can get. Hit the button a couple more times. Orange. Maybe yellow. Yellow sounds good. Let's do that. All right. And one. And a two. And give me the prize. All right. And what's in this one? Pufferfish. another troll box. But that's not all. There are actual big prizes in there. There's some full netherite armor sets. There's full beacons. There may or may not be a block of netherite inside of there. Lots of things worth lots of diamonds. And some kind of trolly funny things. I am going to go ahead and take these and, of course, recolor and redistribute them inside of our system. But let's go ahead and move on to some of the other games and actually give myself some diamonds, because the rest of these games take diamonds. So on the opposite side of the room, we have Double or Nothing. And like it says, you can get two diamonds or you get nothing. So let's drop a couple diamonds in here. Hit the button. So nothing. Nothing. And two. So there you go. That's that game. Pretty simple, self-explanatory. This one, the color wheel, is a lot more fancy. So this is a match three slot machine. And the way this works is if you match emerald or gold, you're going to get five. We're going to have to fix this. You win five diamonds. There we go. And if you match all diamond blocks, you win 12 diamonds. If you match nothing, you win nothing. So we're going to throw some diamonds in there, and then we can hit the button. Nope. No winner. Let's try it again. All right, we did it. Five diamonds, just like that. And then the last thing that we can play over here is not necessarily a redstone game, but it's Stat Poker. And, you know, I'm sure a lot of you have seen Hermitcraft. You kind of know how Stat Poker works. So Stat Poker, you essentially, you have some of your friends gather around here and you bet on your different player stats. So, for example, if I hit this button right here, we've got a stat. So this is damage dealt. So I will go into my stats and see damage dealt. We've got 192,744. In this case, being that the light is on, the higher stat is going to win. So if I was playing with other people and my stat was the highest, then of course I would win that. But the whole point is you place bets without knowing what the other players have, of course, just like you would with poker. And then, of course, you reveal your hand or your stat when you're done with the actual round. So, pretty fun to play. We'll have to check that out another maybe stream day or something like that. And then the stats just go back down in there and get cycled through the system. This light can be on or off. So if it's actually off, you want a lower stat. So that can come in handy for some of the other things. But once again, you know, with these rooms, I wanted to also, you know, play a lot with the lighting. So as you see here, we've got a lot of different colors going on. We got some of the cyan, we got some red light from the torches, and I even got some particle effects with all of the different ender chests in the walls there. So I think it turned out really well, and I'm glad to finally get to open this for the rest of the cast members to enjoy. All right, well, now that we've wrapped up building over in the saltwater sewers, it's time to announce a brand new game for the cast members and supporting cast on the server. So let's go check it out. All right, a small hop, skip, and jump over here brings us to this brand new portal. This is the One Chunk Challenge. The One Chunk Challenge is something that I've had the pleasure of taking part in. Also, another throwback to Collusion MC. Lots of fond memories there. It's a build competition that exists on One Chunk Plots. And down below here, you'll see we have 24 of those plots available. Now, you have basically a month to build something in this One Chunk, constrained within this small little area. Well, you know, maybe not vertically, but at least horizontally. And on top of that, you will have to incorporate secret ingredient blocks that aren't so secret because we can see them all right here. Of course, the players are not going to know what block they're going to get, so they'll have to find out what it is when they sign up. And to sign up, they'll just simply come over here, take a look at this book, read the instructions. So essentially, build competition, as I stated. You're going to be given a secret block by selecting the button down here that's going to pull out a random block for you. Then you're going to rename that block with your name. Prizes are going to be very large. Best overall build, and this is going to be by third-party judges, 64 diamond blocks. Also awarding 32 diamond blocks for most creative and 32 diamond blocks for the best use of the secret ingredients. So there's a lot of money on the line, but everybody is going to be getting participation prizes, so you'll always get something for participating. And then this is the instructions on how to do it. Essentially, take one block, you know, no peekies, and put it in here, rename it with your name, and then go find your plot. Each one of these blocks is, you have a stack of those and you have to incorporate it into the build. And these, I picked the most unconventional blocks, as you can see, to use. So a little bit of a spoiler here. Some are a little bit more conventional, like, you know, the birch wood over there. Some, on the other hand, are a little less conventional, say, like, you know, a wet sponge or TNT. So that'll be fun to see how the players and cast members decide to incorporate that. Game on! And get some judges in here, and they're going to judge your work because I can't be impartial. How could I with this wonderful group of people? All right, well, that's it all out of the way. Let's head on over to check on the progress of our water ride. All right, we're over here in my redstone build testing world, and I have lots of progress to show you. So let's get started here. First off, right behind me, you'll see is our water ride. We have the full path set up, and I've started to kind of box out the different show buildings and rooms, so kind of color coded down below here. Everything in orange is going to be kind of encompassing a giant lumber mill, and then of course green being some of the areas that are going to be a little bit more terraformed and landscaped. And then of course in the back here is going to be our giant mountain that's going to tower above everything that will house a lot of the ride itself. And yeah, so with that, like I said, I've been working slowly on this to try to get this all boxed out. Also figuring out how far apart to space these boats, which is going to be incredibly important because we are going to be having a mini game in this whole thing, which is going to be target shooting. And we have to score the different players scores individually. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to be having these different redstone systems built into each section of the map. And you can kind of see some of these here indicated by our red blocks as kind of the barrier of when we're going to be switching different sections. So that is, I think, representing an NPC that I'm going to have here as well. And the way we've got that working is actually reusing some of the redstone I put together for our junkyard game last season. So we have a couple different pieces. So the first one over here is an incrementer. And the way this works is every time that a pulse comes in on this line right here, it's going to increment this down one. And what that does is that'll actually open up a different channel that the pulse for a score. So anytime we hit an object, it's going to send a pulse through on the scoring channel. And that's going to send it to the appropriate scoreboard for each of the boats. So essentially, if you can imagine, we have like boat number one, it's going to go through the first room. So the first room is going to be set to boat one. And then when that boat leaves the area, the second boat will come in, then the room will be set to boat two. And that's going to increment each way or each time. And you're going to have one of these machines right here, or components, modules, I guess, that's going to be part of every section of the map. And in total, we're going to have, I think, about 14 boats that are going to be separated by 35 seconds each. So this allows us to have multiple players riding the ride at the same time, but the scores are going to be all separate, which is going to be super nice. And then speaking of scoring, I've already mocked up one of the kind of targets that we're going to be shooting. And you may remember we kind of showed this off somewhere. Oh, yes, way over there a while back. Oh, spoilers. We made raccoons. So those are reskinned minecarts. And as you can see over here, we have different types. So there's going to be ones that are running across, so it looks like you can see them running with their feet moving and everything. They're all minecarts, of course. So we're going to be target shooting minecarts. But it's kind of cool because, they look like, of course, raccoons. And then along with that, so this system works that it's breaking the minecart every time it gets down to the end of the line. However, if we shoot it with an arrow, it's going to break apart above these hoppers. These hoppers then, as the item is going down to the beginning where it's going to get recycled, it then hits this point that triggers the scoring system to increment it by one. And so the goal will be to try to shoot these as fast as possible because that'll recycle them as fast as possible and then your score can go even higher. That's not the only ones. Of course, we're going to have some jumping out of things. Some that you may have to hit target blocks in order to actually trigger those to go up. Let's see here. So all the way over here, these are some of the other designs. So it being a minecart, I think I mentioned this before, it's a little bit challenging because as a minecart, it looks like it's going in four different directions on these different tracks. It's actually only facing two different directions. So I had to create variations of the minecart, some that are facing, certain directions, either like north, northeast and, southwest, just to basically get all the combinations of the directions I want these different raccoons to go in. These fun little guys spinning around, those are the ones that are going to be jumping up in the air. So you may remember before when we showed this off, we had a minecart kind of going up in the air. Well, now we have a raccoon and he looks so silly. Same process here. Essentially, when we shoot the raccoon, it's going to end up in one of these hoppers right here or this one right here. And then that's going to increment the score. If it ends up down here, then of course it doesn't score anything and it just gets recycled through. That's popping out because that is full. So yeah, that's the progress I have so far. It's going a lot slower than I wish it were going. I wish this was done already because I'm really excited to show you guys how this is going to really turn out. Also, talking about the whole show building here. So I've figured out where we're going to be entering and exiting. So essentially, this red line is kind of the ground level, if you will, for these rides. So we're going to come in. There's going to be a bridge over this right here. This is going to be kind of down in the valley. And up here, we're going to have our queue line. And of course, this is where we're going to enter into the ride. And so we'll be getting on different boats over here. Then, of course, once this goes through the whole ride, you end up down in the bottom here, which this is our final tunnel that goes all the way back up. And we'll have scores posted here. One of the things I'm planning on doing, now we could do this completely vanilla and have just a system where each of the boats, you know, you'll have to remember what number boat it is, and you'll have to go to a corresponding barrel that would have, you know, your score on there, and then you would have a certain time limit to write, you know, basically look at that barrel, see, okay, I got, you know, say 40 points or something, and then go to a lectern and record everything in a book and write your name there and all that stuff. That sounds like a lot of trouble, and I don't want to do that. So instead, we're going to use data packs. So what a data pack is going to allow us to do is actually have it write to a scoreboard, which is, you know, technically a Minecraft vanilla feature. And we're going to be able to get a really cool display using some armor stands and procedurally updated armor stand names. So essentially, you're going to have a floating scoreboard, if you imagine. It's going to have each of the player's scores, and it's going to be ranked based off of the number of points that they have. So you'll see first, second, third, fourth. And it'll allow people to see what they've scored and also, you know, what they need to get a better score to try to, like, beat the other players. And then I think what we'll do with that is have some prizes, maybe like different trophies that folks can get. And I want to have a kind of similar system for some of the other rides that are going to be in the park as well. So I know there's one other, like, racing ride that I want to have times that you're trying to get the lowest time. And of course, it'll be ordered a little bit differently. So there's that. And then, of course, we're going to exit down over here. This will go back into the ride if you just want to hop right back in there. And then this, like any theme park, is going to be your gift shop. And so we're going to have a gift shop down here with all sorts of themed tchotchkes that you can get for the ride. So I think that's going to be really fun. It's just a lot of work, unfortunately, to get all this we're going, and it's been slow going. So I'm trying to get this, you know, fast tracked to get it done. I know we need to get to the theme park, and, you know, I think we may have to actually start the theme park before this ride is ready to go. So, because I don't want the cast members and you guys to wait any longer. So hopefully we'll get started on that very soon. Can't promise the next episode, but soon enough. So I want to thank you guys for tuning in and checking things out and, you know, subscribing, liking, doing all that fun things. And then, hey, if you discovered us, go check out the Channel 64 community Discord link down below. I highly recommend checking that out. Also, any of the different machines and stuff that I've built during this episode, there's been a lot from other creators. I've shouted them down below, linked to their videos for some of those gambling machines and build ideas and stuff like that. Because, you know, as a community, we can't do enough to make sure that people get the proper credit that they have for things. So, anyways, safe travels, everyone. Thank you.